Shortly after, when everyone left the scene, Quando Rondo will go live.
Come on, Vic, bro, you got this shit, dog. Come on, cuz, just keep breathing, Vic, bro.
Come on.
Just keep breathing, cuz.
Come on,
you got it,
bro.
My fault, my.
It's crazy, cuz that's dude he just stole off of. Mm. Quando Rondo, he a rapper too. And that
it's sad and it's heartbreaking. It, you know, when I heard that he died, it definitely made me sad. I definitely felt the tug at my emotions. All these young people just dying and getting killed. It's just terrible. It's just a sad thing. There's too much out here in this world to live life for our family, our children, for ourselves, not to die so young just so you can leave a legacy of, oh, he was this great person. Granted, we want to be able to leave that legacy, but at the same time, we want to live a full, long life. Mm-hmm. A full, long life.
I'm from the dungeons like a ninja turtle. My life is hell, I ride on the flames, look like I'm surfing. Adidas jogging suit on me like I'm jumping hurdles. Big old backwood in my hand while I'm driving, I'm swerving.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Lice, and I'm back at you with that bitch! Yes, sir! And tonight, we back with my mom, man. Y'all know by the title, y'all know why we here. A lot of people have been waiting on this one, man. They all been wanting me to tell my mom about the stuff that happened. She already heard something about this all over the internet. Man, King Von, rest in peace. You feel me?
Man.
One of our most viewed video is the King Von crazy story reaction. So it's only right that we go ahead and pay our respects to King Von and go ahead and check out a little bit of information on him. This is a video. It's called Chi-Raq Street Legends, Grandson Reloaded, The Craziest Story, Part 1 and 2. We're going to watch both of them. Part 2 came out yesterday, so we can finally do the reaction, okay? We're just going to talk about King Von and about what happened. And then we probably will check out a different video about the manager and explaining what happened and stuff like that. So you know about what happened, right? Like with King Von.
Kind of, sort of, not really.
He
was shot.
He was shot, yeah, over some beef, over some goofy stuff. We're going to go ahead and find out. We're going to check it out right now. Okay, you ready, Mom?
Let's do it.
All right. So we're about to go ahead and get straight to it. If y'all new to the channel, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Y'all already know how this go. We're on the way to the top. We ain't gonna stop on the road to 100K. Let's get it. Push and play in 3, 2. Let me go ahead and go full screen real quick. 3, 2, 1, bow.
It's your boy SNTV, back at y'all with another Chi-Raq Street Legends, and this episode is going to be about none other than Grandson, aka King Von.
Man, this street shit all bad on King Dad. I done lost everybody. I'm pulling on him. Everybody dying, everybody in jail, everybody dead. I'm getting lawyer, funeral. Streets on King Dad. It's life though, you see what I'm saying? Choose your life. We having fun, we out here.
King Von is originally from Killer Ward, 78 to Hermitage. He actually went to grammar school on 76 in Walcott at an elementary school called Barton Elementary. From kindergarten through 8th grade, Von was pretty much a good kid. He really got into sports, but when he made it to high school, that's when he began to really get into the streets. He went to Hyde Park Academy. Von's criminal life will begin around the time he was making his transition from Killer Ward to O Block. O Block is a set of BDs located from 63rd to 66th, King Drive to South Calumet. Their main block is 64th and King Drive. They have friction with 051, Gyro City, Typhoon World, MOB, and their main ops is STL EBT. They're clicked up with 600, 300, THF, the 30 Boys, NLMB, and Front Street.
Yeah!
You know any of them?
Never heard name one of them.
Yeah. She ain't got no pennies. King Davis. But see that cellulose, huh? Yeah.
Vaughn would end up catching a robbery and a carjacking case at the age of only 15. The DA would agree to drop the charges if King Vaughn would agree to go to boot camp. So that's exactly what he did. King Vaughn would get out. Shortly after getting out, King Vaughn would catch a gun charge. The first time King Vaughn would do 14 months, he would end up doing 15 months on the gun charge. After he would be released, a short time later, he would then catch a first degree murder charge and two attempted murders. King Vaughn was no longer a juvenile, so he was going to have to fight for his life now. King Vaughn was looking at more than 100 years if convicted. In May of 2014, King Vaughn and the guy that goes by the name of Michael Wade, who is said to actually be Wooski's brother.
Remember we reacted to that? You remember those two mugshots? What? We take that out. I'll put a clip right here.
Malcolm Stuckey unfortunately got shot in the head and died later that day. The two were held without bond and were facing life in prison for charges of first degree murder and two attempted murders. After sitting in jail for...
If I remember.
You don't remember.
Went to a party on 57th and LaSalle. At this party, King Vaughn would encounter a guy mugging him. A guy that went by the name of Malcolm Stuckey. Well, apparently King Vaughn didn't like the fact that Malcolm Stuckey was mugging him. So him and Big Mike left the party. Him and Mike would come back to the party and catch Malcolm Stuckey on the porch with two other guys. They would open fire, killing Malcolm Stuckey and injuring the other two guys. The police would arrest him in July for this murder. King Vaughn would be charged with one murder and two attempted murders. Well, King Vaughn never said anything to the police. Big Mike, on the other hand, actually told on King Vaughn and admitted to firing 15 or 16 shots at the three people that were sitting on the porch. King Vaughn would end up beating his case because of insufficient evidence, and the witnesses that they had were unreliable. He would be set free at the end of 2017. King,
he's facing 100 years, got set free. He ain't saying nothing, other dude, remember? And other dudes in jail.
It vaguely sounds familiar.
It's been a minute, it's been a good minute, like months. But I'm sure some of y'all remember that, you feel me?
The OGs. Is also identified with a couple more bodies. One of them being the guy that went by the name of Modell from STL. Also, King Vaughn is thought to be one of the people that was on the STL KI hit when Butter was also shot. It was somebody definitely with Big A. And word is, it was King Vaughn.
It's me outside. Body into attack.
Man, bitch. Folks golden, bitch. And I got a lot of
bands.
Folks golden, bitch. Hell, I'm not even... Folks golden, bitch.
Shout out, I got a lot of BJ.
They know. They y'all know what I'm going.
No doubt.
Y'all motherfuckers get busy on time.
Just free, how many y'all think? No, you stop there.
Nah, you
gay.
Hey, look.
That's
what y'all think? What y'all think? Or y'all think this ass all cap?
More than five.
What y'all think his ass all cap?
What? He said 20, he said 6.
Wow.
Ah. That's crazy.
Maybe cap.
I'll take it out. Yeah. I'll take it
out. I mean, it's all shit.
I'm on 45.
On 45, what?
Ah, shut up.
My brother said numbers and shit.
They put numbers up there. They put numbers up there. No, I'm just playing, man. We try to
talk shit. I'm ready to talk shit. No.
Hey,
y'all
get
off that scary shit, y'all.
Hey,
y'all getting scary. Stop being so scary.
There you go.
Damn. After beating his case, Vaughn would hit the streets. Vaughn had been watching Dirk and seeing what Dirk was doing in the rap game.
Dirk. You remember Lil Dirk, right? That's an old picture of Lil Durk. His dress is way longer than
he got the
blonde hair. The blonde dress.
Would encourage Von to go ahead and start rapping. Just so happened, Von turned out to be good at it. And Durk seen that. Von went in the studio, wrote a song, recorded it, shot a video. Durk posted it on his channel, and that was all she wrote.
Call the body, beat that body, catch some more. See niggas be rising, I think want some problems. Got a drop on this flexin' nigga. He from Tennessee, just bought a clock with a ruler clip. Boy, don't play with me.
Von's success will come at a rate that was so fast that if you blinked an eye, you might have missed it. He would blow with the help of Durk, using the art of storytelling mixed with drill. This was something that a lot of the younger drill fans had never heard. Plus, they had a real street figure that they could look up to. And if there's anything that I know about Chicago, Chicago loves gangsters. You could be a gangster in Chicago and do something small, and it becomes bigger, strictly based off the fact that you have juice in the streets. Von will have one of the fastest blowups ever seen in drill and rap history. But Von also would hold a vendetta. When Von was locked up, his best friend T-Roy was killed in 2017. This was something that Von harbored because Von and T-Roy called themselves twins. They were always together. They did a lot of dirt together. They came up from the same place, Mud Brothers. So even when Von did get money, Von was still on that. You would always catch Von dissing his ops. In Von's mind, it was up there and it was stuck there. And there was nothing nobody can do to turn it down. T-Roy was killed in Paxtown in 2017 after he was over East looking for TB, who at the time was Tyquan World's biggest hitter. T-Roy was spotted and the call was made to TB. TB would get the drop on T-Roy and end up killing him. Von was locked up, so this crushed him.
Now you know, that nigga Melly, now he one of them niggas you can talk to, you know what I'm saying? You can talk to him because he cool, and he got a little points, whatever he did, you know? So it's okay. Now he tell me, I hide the nigga and shit. The nigga, I mean, he did right now. But like, he tell me that's when he's alive. He like, I knew you was gonna get out shorty. You lost your best friend. God had to let you out. You see what I'm saying? Like, God, he owes you that. I said, that's some real shit for a bitch ass, pop ass nigga to say, okay, babe? But he told me, like, yeah. He said, yeah, see, I said, I knew you was gonna. I said, yeah, that'd kill my man. I couldn't believe that. Fuck it, 30 days, 30 nights. Fuck it, on King Dave. Fucking on King Dave, babe. It ain't got enough. Y'all tripping.
And this would just be another chapter in the war between Old Block and STL. In February of 2019, King Von and Durk's name would come up in a situation that took place at the Varsity Restaurant downtown Atlanta. Now, if you know anything about Atlanta, you know that the Varsity Restaurant is pretty much a landmark. The situation that occurred had something to do with a guy being shot and robbed. And allegedly, King Von and Durk would have something to do with this. They will both be charged. After their bonds will be met, there will be certain rules set in place. One being, they can have no contact with each other, and they couldn't be around each other. You would think that this would hinder the OTF movement, but it didn't. It actually kind of made them go harder, as Durk will continue to do what he's been doing, and Von will continue his rise to the top. Also, Von was a different type of guy when it came to his block and helping out the community. Von would go to his block and give away $100,000. Just for the people that he grew up with and for the people that he loved the most and for the people that loved him. Also, Von would do stuff like giveaways. He also did a food drive. And this is the type of stuff that made him who he was. This is the type of stuff that earned him the king in his name. Vaughn will post a flyer on his Instagram letting everybody know where his album release party was gonna be. He was about to get ready to release his project, Welcome to O Block. It was also his cousin Boss Top's birthday, so they figured, why not kill two birds with one stone and go ahead and celebrate everything? Vaughn posted to his Twitter exactly where he was gonna be, and that he wasn't scared, he wasn't high. The night started off lovely. Everything went according to plan.
Jay Biz with P. Diddy them right now.
It wasn't until after the club was over with that everything began.
Lounge up the street, there was a incident where two groups of individuals got into a physical altercation. That physical altercation escalated into an exchange of gunfire with those groups. Two police officers who were working at that particular club or lounge noticed the gunfire, noticed the altercation, and engaged some of the people involved. There was a exchange of gunfire with police as well. At this particular point in time, we have about five individuals who have been shot. Two are deceased, one is in critical condition, and two are stable.
Police shot King Von and two of the people. Social media is active with, they're upset with the police. So if we have any jobs in Parkway, send two cars every time, okay? And keep your eyes open, be wary. They're not happy with the police over there.
Facebook shops, your customers.
All right, that's part one. We're about to go ahead and go straight into part two. Okay, what you think so far though? It's crazy, yeah. crazy story. The craziest story is what the video is titled. All right, so let's go ahead and finish it out. Part two, 3, 2, 1, bow.
Album release party. King Von was having an album release party for his album that had just dropped, Welcome to O Block. They were also celebrating.
He like literally just dropped. I think it was like the day before he was killed, or a couple days before.
A birthday bash for his cousin, Boss Top. Also, a couple of his artists had just signed deals. So this was an all around celebration. Everything went well at Club Opium, and the plan was to go back to the hotel when they left the club. They would leave the club, and all of a sudden, Von would have a change of heart. Well, Von wouldn't notify nobody in his camp until after he was already at the Monaco Hookah Lounge. Someone alerted Von that Quando Rondo was asleep parked in the car. Rondo would wake up, and when he came to, he would see the OTF member standing in the parking lot. He would immediately hop out the car. Von would walk up on Quando Rondo and punch Quando Rondo in the face. Not even 3 seconds later, Lil' Tim will hop out of the white SUV and shoot Von in his back 3 times. He would also shoot Von's manager. After Von and his manager were shot, Lil' Tim would also be shot. Those first couple of shots would send off a chain reaction, and two off-duty police officers would begin firing excessively. During this process, Slutty, the older brother of HK and T-Roy, would be killed. Also, Louis from O Block, who was a good friend of King Von's, would be shot and placed in critical condition. After this altercation took place, you would see Von holding Rondo and Rondo telling everyone that Von was shot. Soon after, you would see someone who comes up and takes off on Rondo, knocking him down. This someone was Muwop. Shortly after, when everyone left the scene, Quando Rondo will go live.
Come on, Vic, bro, you got this shit, dog. Come on, cuz, just keep breathing, Vic, bro. Come on. Just keep breathing, cuz.
Come on, you can't move on that thing.
You got it, my fault.
It's crazy, cuz that's dude he just stole off of. Mm. Quando Rondo, he a rapper too. And they had a whole beef together. 4K Trey and OTF. King Von and them was basically beefing. Youngboy, NBA Youngboy, he not. That's his homie. He a rapper, a big rapper. We've reacted to him before. He had that Dirty Diana, that song. But yeah, so they in the whole gang together, 4K Trey and OTF, they was beefing. Von just punched him in the face. He got shot. He telling he like trying to help him out because he got shot.
Online. Yeah? Man, he's shot. What you mean we're outside? Come on. Come on. Come on, man. Please. Come on. All right.
Okay.
Get him. Get him a wheelchair. Man, what you mean I gotta stay right here? Man, we need to get him. Man, we need to get him back. They ASAP.
I'm calling.
Just a short time later, Lil' Tim would be caught and charged with the murder of King Von. And King Von's death would be heard around the world, with lots of celebrities sending their condolences. King Von's autopsy photos would also be shared. The internet would get a hold to him, and they would also make memes about the death of King Von. Even though King Von was disrespectful, I don't think that he would have stooped this low. I feel as though the death of King Von was an unfortunate situation. It was a situation that happened so fast to the point to where nobody really knew exactly what was going on until it was too late. King Von's friends and security were behind him. King Von had in his mind that he was gonna fight Quando Rondo one-on-one, and that was gonna be that. But Lil' Tim had other plans. He seen all of those guys coming behind King Von. He got scared. He jumped out the car, pulled out, and killed King Von. This was all verified by King Von's manager, who ended up doing an interview with DJ Academics. And I think that
short clip,
what we can learn from the life and death of King Von is this. No matter what position you get in life, never give up. Continue to fight, because you never know what the outcome is going to be. King Von had just beat a murder and two attempted murders. And there he was on top of the world. And even though his run may not have lasted long, I can honestly say that King Von lived his life before he died. We have to understand in life our position. And sometimes we get caught up thinking in our old ways, and those old ways can get us injured a lot of times. King Von was no longer the street King Von. He was no longer the guy that came from the streets that was putting in work. He was the king. He was the one that should have been protected at all costs. And it's sad to say, but ultimately, King Von's decision making is what got him killed. This has been the story of King Von. Rest in peace to all of those who have lost their lives to foolishness. It's your boy, SCNTV.
Boom. That is the craziest story. Chirac Street Residence, Grandson Reloaded, King Von. That's a little bit, that's a lot of bit about King Von, how he came up. His story behind him, how he just passed, was killed. We've seen a lot of footage. What you think?
Man, it's sad. And it's heartbreaking. It, you know, when I heard that he died, it definitely made me sad. I definitely felt the tug at my emotions. Even now, just watching the video.
When I told her about it, she was like, oh, ain't that the storytelling dude?
Right.
That's how you know.
Remember him? Yeah. Yeah. Because I like the storytelling music. He was
right.
It keeps you engaged. Listen to the story. It was entertaining. It was dope. He was talented. He definitely was, and very handsome.
And it's crazy because, you know, like 3-4 months ago, FBG Duck was just killed too, and that was his like rival. They was going back and forth with that, and then boom, 3 months later, King Von got killed. Random, crazy.
All these young people just dying and getting killed. It's just terrible. It's just a sad thing. It's too much out here in this world to live life for our family, our children, for ourselves, not to die so young just so you can leave a legacy of, oh, he was this great person. Granted, we want to be able to leave that legacy, but at the same time, we want to live a full, long life.
Mm-hmm.
A full, long life.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm talking about.
With a whole bunch of money.
Man.
And success.
Man, family, you know, love.
All definitely. That definitely. Too. That's good, too.
Man, breaks my heart. It's very sad for him and his family. His children, you know?
Yeah, his mother. Kids.
Right, you know, there's so many people who are hurting behind that loss.
Mm-hmm.
It's heartbreaking.
Over some nonsense bull.
Man, it's just not even worth, you know, losing your life over, you know, some bogus beef because someone don't like you because of something that they said, you know, because they live a certain way and you live one way. Now we got to fight about it and someone's got to die. It's not worth taking someone's life. Not at all.
No cap. Mm-mm. No cap. That's what it is. That's how it is. That is. My mom reacted to King Von, the breaking the news to her, showing her that we definitely about to go ahead and check out this other video of the manager talking to DJ Academic. So make sure y'all tune into that one. It'll be the last video about the whole situation. I know y'all been waiting for it, so I'm gonna go ahead and give that to y'all. But go ahead, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, all that good stuff. Y'all know how this go. Rest in peace to King Von, everything like that.
I think we're gonna get to hear his music too, right? We're gonna listen to the new album.
You gonna listen to it?
I mean, we're gonna check it out at some point, right?
Yeah, we're gonna check out some of the songs. I haven't heard.
Definitely, I wanna hear.
I heard one song. That's it. But okay, bet. We definitely gonna do that. Be tuned for that too. Soon. All that. We're gonna see y'all real soon. So much love.
Peace.
Peace.